Right.
You should see the song and dance I got.
Okay.
I mean, I had to go through, I mean, I had witnesses. I had to take a witness with me to get my money out of the bank because I was having such a tough time. I didn't want to get arrested. It's like trying
And that's how bad it is now. I don't even have that much money, and I try to take some out to pay payrolls in emergency, and the bastards wouldn't even give me like 10 grand.
I had to sign all these things. I mean, it was a real song and dance. So that's why they're not giving you your money. They're trying to stall you, and they're going to tell you, they're going to give you all the reasons why you shouldn't take it out.
While the big money guys pull all their money out. See, they're only waiting while they get all their assets out.
You got it.
Again, he's talking about bank runs by, next February?
Yes, we see them happening by February.
My.
Okay, anything else, Aaron?
Should we keep our money in the bank?
Absolutely not.
Well, I can't tell you what you to do, but I'll tell you what I do. We only keep enough money in the banks to for our operating expenses.
That's what I do.
As soon as it hits a certain level, it's out.
Yeah, that's what we do. And, of course, I'm not really in the job to even capitalize. Our job is getting the word out, so we don't have that big of a problem of a bunch of surplus. But we keep in there what we need to operate. But if they have a bank holiday, my office may even shut down, folks. You may hear us on air saying, send us money, because that's the type of situation. I mean, talk about confidence being lost, Gerald. What's going to happen if they do that?
Well, again, they don't do these things that overtly. They always put smoke screens around it. They're going to tell everybody how good it is for them, how we're salvaging the problem, and blaming somebody else. They'll blame, the majority of the sheeple will believe it.
Yeah, one more call. Appreciate the call, Aaron. Sheila in California, you're on the air with Gerald Celente. You can go to his website at trendsresearch.com.
Excellent. Thank you. I'm kind of new to your show, so you might have addressed this before, but it's a two-part question, excuse me, and what it has to deal with is, with the bankers getting their bailouts and there's pretty much no accountability, there's talk of many I know that say, well, I'm in debt at this point in time, and I'm a renter, and why should I pay my credit card debt, my student loans, et cetera? Why shouldn't I just take my credit cards, put it into a debt settlement, and lessen my load? And I'm asking this question because what I want to know is there any laws that you all are aware of that say, those who do this have to pay it off in civil service
or
whatever?
Yes, they're trying to strengthen it where the little guy has to pay back, but the big bankers and others don't have to. But a lot of people are purposefully running up cards. They're rebelling. It's kind of like a tax revolt, but it's overall a credit revolt. Gerald?
Well, let's remember who's the one that put in these pernicious bankruptcy laws was Joe Biden, the governor of the loophole state, Delaware. He was the one that made it so hard for everybody, but gives the big guys the break. But don't forget, they're going to go after you no matter what. These are people that know no bounds. They'll get your first child if that's what they have to do. It's not going to be an easy ride to get off the hook.
Yeah, people keep saying, well, why should I have gold? They might come take it. They might come blow your head off and put you in a FEMA camp. Why should I own a gun? They might take it. Exactly, folks. There's no perfect world. We're talking about getting the best position you can. Gerald?
Yeah, listen, I own both, gold and guns. So, as a matter of fact, that's where all my investments, other than the Trends Research Institute and my own properties, that I'm totally invested in.
Conservatively, and I'm going to let you go, and then we're going to have you back up in another month. You've agreed to do that, and we appreciate it. When do you think gold's going to hit 2,000?
It's hard to say because, as these markets are being manipulated in front of our eyes. Remember, they wouldn't allow short selling. The game is being rigged. It's not even pulling a rabbit out of a hat. There's no hat. So we know that they are there report after report of banks buying tens of thousands of COMEX gold futures, shorting them, actually, not buying them, selling them, to keep the prices down. We believe that they're going to try to put that this G20 talks that are going on, gold, because once people start buying gold, then all of the fiat paper currencies, the fiat currencies are going to be worth nothing. The worst thing that the governments around the world are going to fear are people buying gold. And by the way, go to any of the websites of the big gold traders, Monex, Kitco, whatever.
They're sold out. They're selling for premiums.
Yeah, and they're selling for premiums, and they're telling you you can't get delivery until a long time because there's a shortage of supply, and the shortage of supply is worldwide.
And that shows the manipulation. You have gold down by 100-and-something bucks, now going back up. Meanwhile, there's 30, 40, 50% premiums, and you can't get it. I mean, talk about global manipulation.
Exactly. So what we're saying is, you know, gold is, and again, we could be wrong. You know, we don't walk on water, and we're only human. But I'm telling you what I do and what I believe, and I put all my investment capital is in gold.
What about silver?
You know, silver's a good one, too, but silver also has production purposes as well. And gold, you know, I would say both of them, but I know gold. I've been following gold. My first buy of gold was in 78 at $187.50 an ounce. And, you know, I've been buying it and following it since that time. So I'm not that well versed in silver as I am gold.
I understand. You trade in what you love and what you know and what you research. Well, Gerald Celente, ladies and gentlemen, the market trend research man, trendresearch.com. Thank you for spending an hour and 20 minutes with us, and we'll talk to you again sometime in December. Godspeed.
Okay, thank you so much. Bye-bye.
You bet. What an amazing individual. We're going to come back. We've got Max Keiser coming up, looking at the economy and taking your phone calls. And then I promise to do it. I boiled down the most powerful 30 minutes of last Friday's hearings. Well, Rob Jacobson has in there in the control room, and we're going to be playing that.